This is an ABC 10 News update.
Good evening, I'm Kimberly Hunt in the ABC 10 News studio. Here are the latest coronavirus numbers in San Diego County. A relatively high percentage of positive tests today is keeping our 14-day rolling average close to 4.5%. The county reported 294 more cases, bringing our total to 43,181. And there were 9 more deaths reported, bringing that total to 742. The state wants to place a sexually violent predator from Humboldt County here in San Diego. Well, next month, a judge will consider whether to place Joshua Cooley in Palma Valley. Cooley was convicted in 2004 of sexual battery against a girl under 12. A court must do extraordinary circumstances to place a predator outside their home county. Well, Humboldt is claiming that such circumstances exist, but we don't know what those are. District Attorney Summer Steffen has written a letter asking the state to remove Palma Valley from consideration. And small businesses around the county are about to get a share of nearly $15 million to help offset losses from the pandemic. Today, county supervisors unanimously approved a series of grants. The money will be divided between 4 of the county's 5 districts. From there, more than 2,000 businesses across the districts will get a grant in the thousands of dollars. District 3, represented by Kristen Gaspar, was not included in today's vote. Her spokesperson says that Gaspar plans to submit her grant proposals later this month. Now let's switch to weather. Meteorologist Angelica Campos is tracking our weather right now for us. Angelica, what's ahead?
Hi, Kim. As summer comes to an end, the temperatures are rising, getting ready for the warmest day of the week as temperatures climb into the upper 80s at the coast and upper 90s in our inland communities. Coming up, I'll show you what to expect for the rest of the week and when we'll see a cool down.